classic K-drama male-led is usually rich and or powerful, ridiculously attractive, and, more often than not, struggling with some dark backstory that triggers either womanizing tendencies or fits of blind rage. He always reforms, grows, and learns from the heroine, and we come to love him by the end of the season. But some dramas, those special few, start out with a super nice lead and just get sweeter from there. See also, Jin Shaeyun reveals how Yoon Shiyun handled their dating reports. Here's our list of 6 things that nice K-drama leads do that get us wishing they weren't so rare in drama land. Soompi. Display. News. English. 300x250, BTF Soompi. Mobile. English. 300x250, ATF1. Creative dates, please. No more forced makeovers or surprise unwanted visits to our homes. That's not quite romantic. Sometimes it's bordering on creeper level and we're over it. Nice guys in dramas have the right idea. Like Enrique, played by the adorable Yoon Shi-yoon, in Flower Boy Next Door. Kodok Mi, played by Park Shin-hye, was so done with the world by the time this guy showed up, but he dragged her out of her comfort zone and they went to the beach. Look at that sandcastle. What a nice treat. Gikata, how about that beautiful island in Descendants of the Sun? Yu Shi Jin, played by Song Junki, would never bring his girlfriend to the mall for a date. Silver Chris, watch Descendants of the Sun, watch now too. No wrist pulling, I mean, it's not really romantic. A quick come over here is just as sufficient, so why are drama leads dragging everyone around by their wrists? It's so common in shows now that even nice characters are doing it. Amino Apps 3, they let the lead be happy in Let's Eat 2. Gu Dae Young, played by the charming Yoon Do Joon, sacrifices himself for Bak Soo Ji, played by Seo Hyun Jin, when he thinks she's happily dating another man and that it's not in her best interest for him to pursue her. No dramatics, no pressure, just a really nice guy who eventually ends up with a girl. Amino Apps, we see far too much selfish behavior from leads these days that's painted as an act of desperate and unflinching love, but it's not realistic. In the real world, that hot chibol would be kicked to the curb for acting like a child. Watch Let's Eat 2, watch now 4, they take responsibilities. Cha Do-hyun, played by the very talented Ji-sung, is a total mess in Kill Me, Heal Me. His multiple personalities are ruining his life and leaving havoc in their wake, but he takes responsibility and cleans up after himself. When he's not chasing other men around calling them Opa, he is a swoon-worthy adult with real charm. Though perhaps part of the appeal of the character was the switch back and forth from nice guy to hot bad boy with any given episode, eyeliner really looked good on him. Pinterest, watch Kill Me, Heal Me, watch now 5, they stay positive. Ugh, there's a lot of drama in K-dramas. And don't get me wrong, I love it. I often find myself on the edge of my seat, popcorn falling out of my mouth as I gasp at the catfight between the heroine and her boyfriend's mother at the mad dash to stop the heroine from leaving the hero after he's done something truly crappy. But if you're looking for a drama with a lead you can pine after, you're looking for someone positive. We can't all be sunshine and smiles all the time, but it's definitely something to aim for. Remember this guy in Strong Woman Da Bong Soon, played by the lovable Park Bo Young, had eyes for a much broodier man, but couldn't help being seduced by the adorable puppiness of this ray of sunshine. Hell, he buys her ice cream and writes their names in the sand. It doesn't even matter that he looks like that, not a factor, didn't even notice. Jive Cat, watch Strong Woman Da Bong Soon, watch now. What do you love about nice guys in K-dramas? Let us know in the comments. Ms. West is an English teacher working in South Korea, accidentally walking up mountains and struggling to use chopsticks, currently watching Rich Man, Poor Woman, Walk of Love, Busted, and Live. Looking forward to My Aju See, and Are You Human Too? All-time favorites, Healer, Reply 1997, and Master's Son.